billiards.com.au, more than just billiards. Come to our online store for great value.
Okay, now that the cushion block is in place, we're ready to start stapling the cloth on over the rubber itself. Now, all you need to do, you're just going to pull it over, make sure it's nice and straight there, put your first staple in. You need a bit of tension on, but you don't want to go berserk, so you're just holding it down, putting in one staple. Now, with the process I'm going to use, I'm taking into account that the person doing this will be one that has limited or no experience whatsoever at doing this, so I'm going to keep moving the cushion around a little bit to do it in a fashion that might make it as easy as possible for you. If you've watched a true fitter at the billiard trade doing his craft at this, you might find him do it one straight way all the time because he's used to doing it. What I'm going to do is do a couple of different ways into one that might make it a bit easier for the novice to have a go at it. Now, once we've stapled there, you're going to have a fair bit of excess cloth. We need to stretch and pull that away. We've got to deal with the end. Remember, this particular set of cushions has the holes in the end where the special pocket brasses go, which we'll show you as it goes back together. You've got to allow for those holes. You've got to cut through the cloth and everything. So there's a little bit of tedious work involved, and we're going to show it more at the other end of the cushion so that you can get a closer view of it. Okay, now just to give a bit closer explanation of doing the ends of the cushions, which are a little bit more difficult because you've got excess cloth that's going to want to gather up and you've got to eradicate that. It's basically just stretching. It is either pure wool or an 80% wool blend, and so it's going to have a reasonable amount of elasticity to it, so you'll be able to stretch it. What we need to do is to, in the case of where we have the two holes in this one, we've got to sort of get them where that's going to be covered up yet exposed, if that makes sense, because we're going to have to cut holes in cloth and all that. We're going to stretch it around the corners, so there's going to be a bit of tension put on. So we might start with that bit. We're just going to pull that around the side, and I'm going to pin it underneath, out of sight. That's put a bit of tension there that you've got to deal with, and we'll get to that. We're just going to come around this corner here. You want it as neat as you can. So we're coming across. That's got a nice flat face to it there. We're just going to drive our staple into the centre of those two holes. That's going to pin that for us. Now, to start off with, we come back under the flat area, pull it straight over. You want it to be straight over the cushion, and you can pin that. Now you've got to eradicate as much of that as possible. This is where you may have to stand it upright, lay it down, whichever way is going to be comfortable for you to do. There's no absolute way of doing it. It's whatever you feel good with. You may even have to put some in to hold, take them back out, so there's nothing wrong with any of that. You just be careful doing it. What I often do sometimes is I'll turn it over and start at the very start of it, put my thumb in position, drive the nose of the staple gun in, and put one into place, then work my way around it, using the nose of the staple gun as best as possible. And that way you can see there that you're getting a nice flat area coming around the corner, and you're driving it in almost back to where the cushion body is itself. So you can just keep doing that around the corner, and you will hopefully be eradicating that excess cloth at the same time. Because it's quite difficult, if you don't be concerned about it. Just take a staple or two out. I've deliberately done one there, where you can leave a bit of a crease. Now, if that happens, just pop a staple out. Right, so that you can gather that back up. And pull it further across, and hopefully that will eradicate that problem for you. All right, well, we've got the cloth down. What we're going to do now is just make a little cut through there. So you just start back. I wouldn't go all the way to the corner, just sheer risk. Start about there. You're just going to cut that cloth away, coming along the outside of those staples, of course. You don't have to come a long way, just through to there. You can cut that off to separate it, and you're just going to pull that a bit tight. And what we're going to do is finish off the end. So you just put one staple in there. If you want to, you can put a staple in there, It's just going to help hold it down. It's not going to make a great deal of difference. We're going to do a similar thing around this side to finish it off. Then we'll run a row of staples along there. Okay, now just to eradicate the excess cloth, sharp bladed knife, just put it in, get the slice started, go into the join and just pull it along. Go and take your time. It's not a job you have to rush, and you'll find that now. Little technique, grab a reasonably new screwdriver with a nice smooth face. Putting it on the rubber itself, you're just going to pull it back towards yourself. Bit of pressure, so pull it back towards yourself like that. And you'll find that you're going to pull that rubber back in a reasonably straight line. The pocket openings themselves, just do a little curve around like that. This one, clamp it there, pull it round, and you find you're pulling the rubber back to reasonably straight. We'll get the rest done and we'll start showing you how to do the bedcloth.